Magic the Gathering is a collectible card game created by mathematics professor Richard Garfield and introduced in 1993 by Wizards of the Coast, which is an American publisher of games primarily based on fantasy and science fiction themes. Magic still thrives today, with an estimated 6 million players in over 70 countries, including South Africa. Each game represents a battle between powerful wizards, known as planeswalkers, who use the magical spells, items, and fantastic creatures depicted on magical cards to defeat their opponents.
The game has five basic colors, okay, which is so-called the five colors of magic. You've got white, blue, black, red, and green. And each of these different forms of magic depends on different sources of it. Now the source of the games itself depend on kind of what kind of magic you use. If you want to use black, then you would be a dark, you know, necromantic magician, so to speak. And so you'd use a lot of creature kill spells, zombies, vampires, those kind of dark mythical things come into play. If you play white, then you're usually playing with the humans. And they have lots of powerful spells in the sense of being able to kill multiple creatures or deal with one or two at a time. The green is the elves, mostly the elves, but other beasts within green magic. Blue is the control, where you usually get to say no, you can't play that. And then red is basically the main grouping within red is the goblins. The way a basic magic game works is you have an opponent, you each start on 20 life points. The key thing in what you're trying to do is you're trying to beat your opponent down to 0 life points. First one on 0, he loses. So you would play creatures and spells accordingly to try and attack your opponent, his life total. He in turn gets to defend himself with creatures that he's played. You see, and that's basically how it was. You can also use spells to negate a life total, or basically there's one other strategy is if an opponent no longer can draw any cards, then he also loses. That's the only alternative strategy to win within Magic. There's only two ways. How do you get started? Okay, you buy a deck. A starter deck is a good way to go. It will cost you approximately a minimum investment of $100 for two decks. You can buy the cards online. You can get them from local stores, which is always preferred because we'd like to promote the local stores. The most powerful cards ever printed in the game is called the Power Nine. The key thing behind the Power Nine, it enabled a player, any player that had them, to do ridiculous amounts of horrible things to every one of their opponents within the shortest amount of time.
I started playing Magic since 2006. I began playing because I saw a bunch of guys at Varsity playing cards and I got very interested in what they were doing and I kind of just got sucked into that vibe. So that's how I got started.
It's a continually changing environment. So in order to actually master it, it's not like chess where it's a static element that you can particularly be the best at. You can be the best for a while, but the things change, the cards change, the feel behind the game at any given time is slightly different.
I've been playing for 18, 19 years, and I still enjoy it. It still stays fresh for me. And the key other thing that I think what makes Magic very exciting is that it's competitive and still very sociable. You know, it's fun. If you like gaming, if you like any form of entertainment where there is a bit of challenge and strategy involved, you know, that's what it is. It's chess with cards.